Hey everyone and welcome! My name is Crash Craze and welcome to my first Call of Duty World War II beta video. I've been grinding out this game and man, I am enjoying it. After a bunch of hours of playing the beta, I've compiled some tips to share with you guys who are either Xbox players who have yet to take a stab at the World War II beta, or if you're just interested in some tips on how to really take advantage of what you're able to access between the beta weekends. These tips are only for the beta, so I'll probably make another one in the future when the game fully comes out. Since we do know that, you know, things are kind of not set in stone between the beta and the full launch of the game. Now, let's get into my top 5 tips for the Call of Duty World War II beta. Tip number 1 is to make complete use of that map that sits on the top left corner of your screen. In the Call of Duty World War II game, the mini-map features a little location of names of precisely where you are, and that's kind of important in how it helps you become familiar with the map each time you play. This helps especially when playing with a group of friends to be able to call out enemies and locate them for your friends to take out and be wary of. The next tip is connected with the first one actually, and that is to actually pay attention to character callouts. I think in Call of Duty World War II, the character callouts are really loud in the game, and that can actually play to your benefit. If your teammate's character calls out that there's an enemy in the trenches, then that's a big cue for you to use that map location and track them down. I've also found that listening for enemy callouts kinda help pinpoint where my targets are as well. Between listening for footsteps and callouts mixed with that map locator, you can potentially get a really good jump on that enemy. Tip number 3. Those divisions are crucial. I find myself really liking the division class system because it really brings a sort of balance in the game. Those of us who have played Call of Duty know that perks like Dead Silence, Ghost, Blast Shield are super useful, and we've grown accustomed to automatically placing our classes in the same old-fashioned way. Now, divisions breaks that, and that makes us choose how to engage in gunfights. Taking the time to settle what loadout to use is crucial for your gameplay, and it's also important to pick and choose what to forego and what to hold on to. Tip number 4, use cover and location to your advantage. The pace of most gunfights, in my opinion, really rely on your location and cover. I've gotten used to running and gunning my way in games like Black Ops 3 and Infinite Warfare, where you can take out your enemies and move quickly from one end of the map to the other. However, I found that utilizing the map is a better strategy rather than running out in the open. There's a good chance you'd run into more than one enemy, and that's never really a good thing. Lastly, the final tip is movement. Now, this is a weird one because there isn't any boost jumping or sliding or gliding or windsurfing or any of that stuff. It is boots on the ground, bro. However, there are still some movements that you can do to psych out the enemy. I'm talking about jump shots and drop shots. This has always been in Call of Duty, and I've definitely had gunfights that went my way by using these movements to get the edge on my enemy. For jump shots, definitely look at going around corners, listen for that enemy, and if you think that they're on the other side, jump right over and see if you can get that shot on. So that's gonna conclude my tips for the Call of Duty World War II beta. I hope that these are helpful to you, and if you have anything to add, be sure to comment them down below. Tell me how you're feeling the beta. Leave a like if you enjoyed, and if you haven't, make sure to smash that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video. I'll see you guys.